clip style axle, meaning there's a small clip inside the differential that holds the axle in. So if the axle shaft breaks, there's nothing to hold the shaft, but also hold the tire on the vehicle. We gotta figure out how to get it out of there without damaging it or the tire falling off and damaging the thing further. We'll see what happens.
So, I feel like everything was going fine until I went to Hell's Gate, and me being an idiot not checking forward up the trail, I didn't know it was like go down and then come back up. I thought it was like go down and then like just take a little dirt road back up.
Right, right. Yeah, it was supposed to get easier, not yeah, more difficult.
I thought that was the difficult part. So I tried to go up the other side and the front CV axle snapped. Trying to go back up the rear, I don't know if it's a diff or the axle just snapped, made some weird noises, and then I was lucky it wasn't the brakes.
Yeah.
So yeah, I just started sliding down and just left it there.
Tracks from attempting to get out of here in two-wheel drive. So they broke the front shaft over there, rear shaft right about there. So here's what we got. We got the front axle shaft there that is not there no more.
Bluetooth.
It's a Bluetooth drive shaft. And then we got potentially a broken shaft. We're not certain exactly, but pretty sure.
No, it looks like it.
Yeah, you can see the gap between the dust cover and the rotor. That one's about an inch apart. That one, it's much less than that, which means the axle shaft is trying to work its way out.
So we just think what we're gonna wanna do, get the racker to the top and then start pulling.
So we got that strap, goes to this strap, which goes to this strap, then to that strap, which is then gonna go to the tow truck. We're gonna have Sean directing traffic, and I'll be standing around holding the camera. Good there?
We got it. got to get up further.
So what do we got happening? You're going to hook that to the winch? Okay.
Mike?
6 inches. 3 inches.
Right
there,
work.
Basically.
So you looking pretty good, centered up?
I'd say it looks,
yeah,
pretty good, yeah.
Hang on.
How was it?
Feeling good now.
Awesome.
It's out. That was the biggest problem.
All right, so now what we did, we switched out for this nice stretchy strap, but it's also really short, which makes it really useful for towing in these kind of conditions.
So this next little bit here is a real steep side hill going this way, and we're worried about that axle shaft coming out. So what we're gonna do, hook Sean to the back of this vehicle, and it's gonna help put some tension that way to hopefully keep this axle shaft together for a little while longer.
Capture it, maybe if I go like this. It's really steep.
Down here, you guys contacting the insurance company. They're gonna come and haul it and get it probably to a repair shop, get it all fixed up. But yeah, our job is done. It is off the trail. This trail recovery is what we do. For the first time in our smart ass careers, we can use this line correctly. Vehicle's recovered, let's go home.
So you come here often?
Oh yeah. So me and Mike broke the scrambulator.
It was mostly Sean. I drove it for like 6 feet. And that's when everybody noticed it was leaking.
Me, Mike, and what's the guy's name?
Brandon.
Brandon.
All three of us broke the scramble.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, you going this way?